afternoon. In the Super Late Model Dash, Rays fans, pick your favorite out, root them on. This will determine the first three rows for the 8th annual Cabin Fever 40. The youngster Ethan Hunter in the 15, the veteran Dale McDowell in the 17M, will bring him to green here off turn four. Eyes on him. Green's out of here we go. The drag race down the front straightaway to turn number one. McDowell going to nose out in front. Hunter will be second. McIntosh trying to work the outside around Hunter. He is third. He'll challenge Hunter for the runner-up spot down in the turn at number three. McIntosh trying to tiptoe around the outside around Hunter. Looks like he may have had the runner-up spot at the start-finish line. McDowell leading the way. But Hunter battling right back under McIntosh. McIntosh now secures the second spot. Punt Hunter to third. Riley Hickman fourth. Jason Hyatt fifth. Tyler Millwood now trying to work around. Hyatt sets the first three rows for the Cabin Fever 40 as we're two laps into it. Going to see the halfway signal this time. There'll be three down, three to go. And Dale McDowell in the Warrior race car, Earnhardt Childress Racing Engine, Bedmore Buggy sponsored 17M, shows the way out in front with three in the books, three to go. Donald McIntosh is second. Ethan Hunter third, Riley Hickman fourth, Jason Hyatt fifth, and Tyler Millwood rides in position number six. Four laps down, two laps remaining here in the Super Late Model Dash, and McDowell continuing to pull away from the field as he motors off the bottom side of turn number four to the white flag. One lap remaining here in the Super Late Model Dash. Down the back straightaway for the final time, Dale McDowell sets that machine down into turn number three off of turn number four. Chickamauga, Georgia's Dale McDowell, the winner of the Super Late Model Dash, with the pole sitter for the Cabin Fever 40. Donald McIntosh will roll home in the second spot. Ethan Hunter will finish third. Riley Hickman comes home fourth. Jason Hyatt fifth. And Tyler Millwood will finish sixth. So your podium finishers out of this one, these will be the first three rows, the top six starters in the Cabin Fever 40. Finishing third, the 15 of Tiger Georgia's Ethan Hunter, second, the 7 of Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh, and the winner of the Super Late Model Dash, and the gentleman that will be the pole sitter for the 2016 Cabin Fever 40 in a Warrior race car with an ECR engine sponsored by Klotz Lubricants, Cometics Gaskets, Team Dillon Racing, Bad Boy Buggies, and Ferris Moores. He's out of Chickamauga, Georgia. Big round of applause for Mac Daddy Dale McDowell. Mr. Deza did not start. That'll move Joey Standridge up to the inside of row number three. 10 laps, the top four will race their way in to the Cabin Fever 40. Eyes on him here off of turn number four. Green flags in the air, here we go. And former Cabin Fever 40 winner Michael Page in the Buster Goss on 24X battling with the T6 of Todd Hernandez. They're side by side down the back straightaway into turn three. Still side by side just like they started here off 4th Street here at Boyd Speedway. Page will nose out in front at the start finish line. And he's going to be clear. Hernandez now off of turn two. Put Michael Page on the point. Hernandez will be second. The J1 of Josh Johnson starting to get in the mix here now as well. He rides in the third spot. The fourth and final transfer spot right now goes to the 7 of Chatsworth, Georgia's Brian Jackson. Getting the top four will transfer as we've got two laps officially scored, eight remaining. He has a race leader, Michael Page, working off turn number four in the 24X machine. He shows the way here in this one with Todd Hernandez second, Josh Johnson third, and Johnson getting some pressure now from the 7 machine of Brian Jackson as we got a car slowed here on the main straightaway. That's the R12 of Blue Ridge, Georgia native Rodney Weeks, and that machine has rolled to a stop with smoke from beneath the race car. Single file nose to tail off turn number four. Eyes on him, green's out, and here we go. And Zach Dunsmore, 97, coming out late. He'll be three laps down, but he has officially joined the fray. Battle for third, Brian Jackson looking beneath Josh Johnson as they work off turn four down the main straightaway. But Michael Page, the 2013 Cabin Fever 40 winner, continues to lead the way out in front. Todd Hernandez second. He has Winchester, Tennessee's Josh Johnson. And the J1 in Chatsworth, Georgia's Brian Jackson battle for that third and fourth position. Down into turn number one. First man on the outside looking in right now is the 56 of Teleco Plains, Tennessee native Joey Standridge. But the front two of Michael Page and Todd Hernandez putting some distance between the battle for third between Josh Johnson and the J1 and the 7 of Brian Jackson. As we are one lap past the official halfway mark, six laps scored, four to go. Field work on lap number 7. We'll have three to go this time by in Super Late Model qualifying heat race number 1. Michael Page being nice and smooth, working the bottom side of turn 1 and 2, working down the back straightaway. Got about 3 car lengths on Todd Hernandez as they work through turns 3 and 4. There'll be 2 laps to go this time for race leader Michael Page and the Buster Goss on 24X machine. Page and Hernandez going to settle this one amongst themselves. Johnson securely into third right now with Brian Jackson fourth as the white flag waves. One lap to settle it here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 1. Michael Page working down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn number 3. And as they work exit turn number 4, Rome George's Michael Page will be the winner of Super Late Model qualifying heat number 1. Todd Hernandez will finish second. Third will be Josh Johnson, and fourth will go to Brian Jackson. So your top 4 finishers that transfer onto the Cabin Fever: 44th, the 7 of Brian Jackson, 3rd to J1, 6 of Todd Hernandez, and taking the win in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 1 in a Rocket with a race engine design power plant beneath the hood, sponsored by M&L Trucking Events plus Buster Goss Body Shop. He's out of Rome, Georgia. Big round of applause for Michael Page. Fair here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 2 as the field getting set to come to the green flag. Derek Ellis in the 99, Jason Manley in the 32, brings him to green, green's out, and here we go. Ellis a little crossways coming off turn number 4, next to that Jason Manley jump out to the race lead. The H31 of Robbie Mason goes to second as Derek Ellis's machine but pushing up the racing surface there, and he's fell back to the fourth spot as Austin Redding in his first ever appearance here at Boyd Speedway pressuring him for that fourth and final transfer spot. Meanwhile, David Brennan in the 33 puts the heat on Robbie Mason for the runner-up spot as they race through turns 3 and 4 down the main straightaway here at Boyd Speedway with 2 laps officially on the scoreboard. Jason Manley with a very comfortable lead here in the early going of this one. Robbie Mason second. David Brandon rides in the 3 spot with Derek Ellis now comfortably in position number 4. Austin Redding, first man on the outside. Look at him right now, the number 94 machine. He rides in 5th. As we'll have 4 laps in the books this time by. It'll be 4 down. 6 to go, and it is all Jason Manley out in front right now. Manley with better than a half straightaway lead. But the battle's starting to heat up for second, third, and fourth. Brandon looking beneath Mason for the bridesmaid spot down the turn at number 1. And Derek Ellis is going to join the fray there as well. All this going on behind race leader Jason Manley as the 7 machine of Craig Greer cleaned the wall off there in turn number 2 just a bit, but continues on. And Manley with about 3/4 of a straightaway advantage now as we get ready to put lap number 7 up on the board. And David Brandon has went to the second spot, put the Ice Bowl winner this year in with Robbie Mason trying to hold down the third position. Derek Ellis right there on his back bumper in fourth as we've got less than two laps to go now. Here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 2, and it is all Jason Manley out of Loudoun, Tennessee. Now the winner of this one will start in position number 8 as the white flag waves, 1 lap to finish it. Super Late Model qualifying heat number 2, Ellis looking beneath Mason for third down the main straightaway. Meanwhile, out front, it is all Jason Manley down the back straightaway for the final time, and now off turn number 4, Loudoun, Tennessee's Jason Manley, the winner of Super Late Model heat number 2, second will be the 33 of David Brennan. Third, going to be the H31 of Robbie Mason. Fourth will go to the 99 of Derek Ellis. And Austin Redding in the 94 completes the top 5. But again, only the top four race away into the Cabin Fever 40, and your top four finishers, fourth to 99 of Derek Ellis, 38-31 of Robbie Mason, second to 33 of David Brennan, and the winner of Super Late Model Heat number two in a CDR race car with a Phantom Race engine sponsored by Motte Muffler and Brakes, Cobbs Auto Parts, and M&M Properties. He's out of Loudoun, Tennessee. Big round of applause, race fans, for Jason Manley. Eastern Young Guns in the 11. That'll be Oxford, Alabama's Cruz Skinner. He is outside the 23 of Chickamauga, Georgia's Craig Burrows. And then the 10 of Murfreesboro, Tennessee's Tommy Taylor, and the G9 of Eric Granger out of Dallas, Georgia, rounds out the field as we come to green off turn number four in Super Late Model Heat number three. Here we go. The battle through turns one and two. Ray Cook got a nose out in front. Jake Knowles in the 66 looks to the inside of Corey Hitchcock. As Hitchcock tries to diamond off that third and fourth corner right there and gets a good run, he'll work back around Knowles for the second position down into turn number one. Cook the leader, Hitchcock second, Knowles is third. The 27, that is Lucas Burns battling with the 23. The other 23, Craig Burrows, for that fourth spot. Again, only the top four will make the show. And unless they've got a fast time provisional, everybody else will transfer to the trailer and be done for the afternoon. Ray Cook shows the way out in front in that Capital Race Cars. And we got a spin over in turn number three and four. The 23 of Chickamauga, Georgia native Craig Burrows loops that machine. Reed lines in fourth as they get set to take the green flag and get back underway. Here we go. And the conga line works down around the bottom of turn one and two down the back straightaway. Hitchcock nose into the outside of Cook. Is he going to try to dime in the corner off? No, he'll go to the outside with a power move around Ray Cook, but we got a car spun up in turn three and four. Eric Granger spins, and the caution will be back out. Tough break there for Corey Hitchcock. Believe he had the pass possibly made on Ray Cook for the race lead with the field in tow. Brings him off the bottom side of turn number four. Green flag waves, and we're back underway. Cook will lead him off turn two down the back straightaway. Cook the leader, Hitchcock second, Knowles is third. The 27 machine of Lucas Burns holds down that fourth spot with the 11 of Cruz Skinner riding in the fifth spot. First spot out on the outside looking in right now with three laps to go. Hitchcock not able to get as good a run there on that restart. Cook was ready for that. And Cook putting a little bit of distance now between himself and second place running Corey Hitchcock. As Hitchcock starting to get some pressure now from the 66 of Rome, Georgia's Jake Knowles down into turn number one. Knowles looking to get a run on Hitchcock, but Hitchcock better off turn two down the back straightaway. As they come to the halfway point of this one, we'll have five down, five to go in Super Late Model qualifying heat number three. And Ray Cook continues to lead the way out in front, with Corey Hitchcock in second, Jake Knowles in third, Lucas Burns fourth, Cruz Skinner fifth. Then we got Eric Granger in sixth, and Craig Burrows rounding out the field in seventh at this point. Yes, Cook starting to put some distance now between himself and Corey Hitchcock for the race lead down the back straightaway and into turn number three. We'll have seven laps complete this time by, seven down, three to go in Super Late Model Heat number three. And it is all Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook out in front. Corey Hitchcock holding down the second spot. Jake Knowles trying to find a way around him from his third position, but has been unsuccessful up to this point, with Lucas Burns out of Atala, Alabama, holding down the fourth and final transfer spot here in heat number three with less than two laps to go in this one now.
Knowles, the fastest car in the racetrack, the last two laps, and over a tenth faster that last lap as the white flag comes out, trying to get around Hitchcock.
Just not able to find a racing room to make his way around Corey Hitchcock, that being Jake Knowles. But the leader, Ray Cook, puts that Capital Race car through turns three and four for the final time. Brasstown, North Carolina's Ray Cook, the winner of Super Late Model Heat number three. Corey Hitchcock will come home in the second spot, and Jake Knowles will finish in position number three with the 27 of Lucas Burns. Rounding out the four transfer spots, the 11 of Cruz Skinner comes up one spot short. He will finish in fifth. So good afternoon here at Boyd Speedway. David Gentry in the 56, Matt Larson in the 25, set to bring him to green off turn number four. Green flags out, and here we go. They'll work down the back straightaway here in Super Late Model Heat number 4. Matt Larson noses out in front in that good-looking number 25 machine. David Gentry second. Ashton Winger holds down the third spot with the 7 of Clint Nichols riding in the fourth and final transfer spot. But he'll get some pressure now from the 5 Emma Scott Shelton down the back straightaway for the fourth and final transfer spot. Sparta, Tennessee, Scott Shelton and one of the Frank Rebel built Revolution race cars. Oh, contact down the front straightaway. And we may have an issue with the 7 machine of Clint Nichols. His car has rolled to a stop. And Matt Larson in charge of the restart brings them back to green here off turn number 4. And here we go. Good start for Larson. He'll have a couple of car lengths on David Gentry off 2 down the back straightaway. Young Ashton Winger in the dozen. The black 12 sits in third with the 5M of Scott Shelton in the fourth and final transfer spot. Is Shelton up on the berm and the edge of the infield a little bit. And that's let Jimmy Sharp Jr. close up on him down into turn number 1. As that pair looks like they may be getting ready to battle for that fourth and final transfer spot here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 4. But out front, Marietta, Georgia, as Matt Larson continues to lead the way. David Gentry getting a lot of pressure from Ashton Winger. You got a veteran and a youngster there going at it for second and a third. Down the back straightaway and into turn number 3. Meanwhile, Matt Larson out of Marietta, Georgia continues to show the way out in front. David Gentry second, Ashton Winger third, Scott Shelton fourth, Jimmy Sharp Jr. first man on the outside looking in. He rides in the fifth spot. Then it's Richard Smith and Stephen Ashby. Yes, it will be one lap past the halfway point right here. 6 laps scored as Winger all over the back bumper of David Gentry that time. Down the front straightaway, and he's going to step to the outside of Gentry in turns 1 and 2, down the back straightaway and into turn 3. The youngster, he's going to try to tiptoe around on the black ice up on the top shelf, and he will make the pass. Give a nod to youth right there, buddy, as he works his way around David Gentry. Ashton Winger goes to the runner-up spot, move Gentry back to third, with Scott Shelton still in the fourth and final transfer spot, as we'll have 8 laps scored right here, 8 down, 2 to go, and Ashton Winger and the black 12 on the move, but I don't know if he's going to have enough time to run down Marietta, Georgia's Matt Larson out in front of this one. But Winger is gaining ground on him, but I just don't think he's going to have enough laps, as the white flag's going to wave 1 lap to settle it here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 4. Larson brings that machine off turn number 2 down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn number 3. And Super Late Model Heat race number 4 will go to Marietta, Georgia's Matt Larson. In the 25, Ashton Winger will come home in second. Third will be David Gentry. Fourth will be Scott Shelton. And completing the top 5 will be the 26 of Jimmy Sharp Jr. But again, only the top 4 transfer on. Green flag is in hand. And as good old JR would say, business is about to pick up. Dale McDowell in the 17M, Donald McIntosh in the 7. They are set to bring them to green here off of turn number 4. Eyes on them, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. It's showtime! McDowell going to jump to the race lead off of turn 2 down the back straightaway. McIntosh going to be second. Hunter and Hickman side by side for third and fourth. Hickman slips up a bit, going to lose a couple of spots as Dale McDowell will lead him through on lap number 1.
Well, big contact now. The front straightaway, Riley Hickman gets into the back of Ethan Hunter, stacks everybody up back to the field, but they'll all continue. Hunter fell a few spots too. He's back to fifth, and good battle for the lead.
Yes, Donald McIntosh down into turn 1. Showed the nose of McDowell, but not able to make a move. But he's going to try to peek under him again as they race off into turn number 3. Good battle up front here in the early going of this one. We'll have 3 laps of 40 in the books. McDowell the leader, McIntosh in the second position. Cabin Fever winner Michael Page in the 24X. He sets in the third spot. Tyler Millwood rides in fourth. Ethan Hunter fifth. Jason Manley sixth. Ray Cook seventh. Todd Hernandez eighth. Riley Hickman right back to ninth. David Brandon sets 10th. And that's your top 10 with 5 laps in the books. 35 to go.
Good run going for Jason Manley right now. 6th place. I'm pretty sure he's in a steelhead. Probably the highest running in the field right now. As McIntosh continues to put pressure on McDowell, it's about a third lead. And McIntosh has it by an inch at the line.
side by side for the lead off of turn two, down the back straightaway, a little contact through four. They're still side by side into turn three and four. Still side by side off of turn four. Give the duke to McIntosh. Dead time by at the line on lap number seven.
Donald McIntosh just talking about how impressive he's been since he got in that ride. Takes the lead from Dale McDowell in his own house. How good is he?
McIntosh putting some distance now between himself and McDowell, while former Cabin Fever winner Michael Page has closed in on McDowell from his third spot. But we got caution. Caution is out as Corey Hedgecock machine slows here on the front straightaway. So the first caution of the event waves with McIntosh with the field in tow. They'll work off turn four, single file nose to tail. Green's back at it. Here we go. McIntosh will lead him off two. Gets a good run off two down the back straightaway. McDowell hangs on to second. Page third. Millwood fourth. Hunter in a fifth as the top ten nose to tail through turns three and four down the front straightaway. As we put lap number nine up on the board, McIntosh starting to flex his muscles similar to what he did at the Hangover 40 back on January 1st at 411 Motors. Just absolutely beat him down in 40 laps and lapped up to the fifth place car up there on that Friday evening, with being New Year's Day. And he's trying to run off and hide into the beautiful sunlight here at Boyd Speedway this afternoon with 11 laps on the board, 29 remain. McIntosh continuing to lead the way. Dale McDowell second. Michael Page about a car length off McDowell's back bumper as they ride into turn number three. Tyler Millwood is fourth. Got a battle for the fifth spot now off turn number four. Jason Manley in the 32 car takes a look beneath Ethan Hunter. And a Manley is going to work his way into the top five. The limited late model winner at the Ice Bowl sitting in the top five right now here at the Cabin Fever 40. As Hunter drifts way up the racetrack in turn four, loses several positions. And you're on lap number 14. The process of working slower, traffic begins.
Donald McIntosh now in the lap traffic, but what a lead. He just checked plumb out. You know, he didn't look that good in hot laps. They've made some great adjustments on that car because he's come out here now and he's just run away with this show.
He has told his crew chief, David Fatmore Bryant, exactly what they needed to do to that race car, and they've got it on the rail right now. As he is showing the way, has put a full straightaway on second place running Dale McDowell. Michael Page third, and Page starting to get some heat now from Tyler Millwood in the 31. And Millwood make contact. Millwood and Page have collected each other up in turn three and four. Oh, my. And that will draw the caution flag.
Oh, Michael. They've worked each other over so hard the last few laps. Tyler Millwood.
Anytime you can race in January, it's an awesome day.
That's exactly right.
Green flag's back out, and here we go. McIntosh with a good restart leads the field down into turn number one. And it's a nice advantage on second place running Dale McDowell off of turn number two. Jason Manley in the 32 sets in the three spot. Ray Cook rides in the fourth position after starting back in the eighth spot. And a fifth right now is the T6 of Rossville, Georgia's Todd Hernandez with a lot of laps here at Boyd Speedway. Keep an eye on that young man here as well as we're putting lap 18 on the scoreboard. And McIntosh opening at lead, last caution, had about a straightaway lead over the second place running machine of Dale McDowell. And McIntosh has cracked the whip on that horse again. And pull it away from the field. Manley stepped out of the groove a little bit, and that's going to open the door for Ray Cook to go to the third spot, move back to the fourth position now. And let's see if the Tar Heel Tiger has anything for MacDaddy now as he chases him down for the runner-up slot. But then all that going on way back behind race leader Donald McIntosh as we're halfway home, 20 down, 20 to go. McIntosh, the leader, McDowell second, Cook third, Manley fourth. Hernandez fifth, Hickman sixth, Brennan seventh, Mason eighth, Knowles ninth, and the seventh machine of Brian Jackson is the final car in the top 10 after starting 17th.
Tough break for Jason Manley. Man, he was working over Dale McDowell hard, starting to work over Ray Cook again, but man, it just doesn't seem like anybody has anything for Donald McIntosh. Back in lap traffic again. Well, it's about a straightaway lead, I'd say. really dominating here this evening.
Yeah, McIntosh clear of a couple of slower cars. Sets his sights on the 97 of Zach Dunsmore now. As he's got clear sailing with the exception of lap traffic. A better than a straightaway lead, almost a half-track lead. Back to second place running Dale McDowell. And he's done that in 8 laps since that restart, man. That is phenomenal. McDowell second, Cook third, Manley fourth. And Hernandez holds down the fifth spot as they're getting lined up single file nose to tail behind second place Dale McDowell. Meanwhile, Donald McIntosh says, boys, y'all just have at it back there, and I'm just going to keep driving away from you. McIntosh entering turn three while the second place battle just entered turn number one. McIntosh with just almost a half-track lead here at this point, 26 laps down, 14 to go. And Donald McIntosh in the Blunt Motorsports Rocket with Vic Hill Power. And that's not their primary car that they're taking to Florida. They brought basically a secondary car here today. And that race car is very, very fast.
Very fast indeed. It almost looks like a primary car as fast as he's going. Hung up a little bit behind a Johnson now. So they keep working through. Got to come in. Tyler Millwood as well. Been watching him the last couple of laps. He's working back through the field, working over David Earl Gentry for the 13th spot. But it is all the Donald McIntosh show right now. It's a good battle heating up for second, third, fourth.
D-Mac in the 7. Looking to put the J1 of Josh Johnson on lap down. They may have made some contact right there entering turn number 1. Johnson may not have knew he was there. And McIntosh now clear of him as we're going to have 10 laps to go this time. 10 laps to go for race leader Donald McIntosh. Dale McDowell still rides in the second position. Ray Cook in the 53 car holds down the third spot. Fourth continues to be the 32 of Jason Manley with the T6 of Todd Hernandez. Holding down the final position in the top 5 with 31 laps now on the board. And Donald McIntosh trying to work his way past the 25 machine of Matt Larson as they enter turn number 3. And, you know, with no radios, he's got to press the issue because he doesn't know how far the second place car is to him. And he's got a very comfortable lead here. You got to wonder if there's any way with hand signals they can motion to maybe for him to just take it easy right here over the final few laps of this one as we'll have 33 laps on the board, this time by 7 to go.
And you got to think sunlight is not their best friend right now, so it's very hard to see anyway. Donald McIntosh has no idea that he is completely checked out. So he's trying to do everything he can to make sure that he keeps making forward progress. But he's really checked out here on Dale McDowell, still holding down second. Ray Cook in third. There's Manley back in fourth. Good run for him, and Hernandez holds down the top 5 spot.
We'll come by and we'll have 5 to go this time for race leader Donald McIntosh. 35 in the books, 5 to go. As Dale McDowell continues to hold down the second spot. Ray Cook had dropped back from him just a little bit, but starting to try to reel him back in here now in the late stages of this event. Mike Daddy second, Patola Hill Tiger third, Jason Manley is fourth, and Todd Hernandez in the T6. Great run for him here today. The Bullet Speedway regular holding down position number 5 as Donald McIntosh continuing to try to work traffic off of turn 4 down the front straightaway with 3 laps to go here now in this one.
Donald McIntosh continuing to try to work through lap traffic's kind of found him a little hole. He settled in, but still about a straightaway lead now. Best battle on the racetrack for 6th as Jake Knowles is going to look low to Riley Hickman. It's going to be 2 laps to go.
The 2 lap to go signal has been shown. Race leader Donald McIntosh is in turn number 3. He's going to bring that machine off of turn number 4 to the white flag. 1 lap to go in the 8th annual Cabin Fever 40. And it has been the D-Mac show since lap number 7 here this afternoon. Into turn 3 for the final time. Race fans, put your hands together. Donald McIntosh, the winner of the 8th annual Cabin Fever 40 here at Bullet Speedway. Dale McDowell will be second, Ray Cook third.
And he's out of the car. Boyd Speedway, give him a great big round of applause. Winner of the 8th annual Cabin Fever 40. Here at Boyd Speedway out of Austinville, Georgia, it's D-Mac, Donald McIntosh. Young man, congratulations. About 4 weeks ago, I talked to you in Victory Lane up at 411 Motor Speedway, and we were joking about it. I said, man, you just turned a monkey loose on them that day, and you lapped up to the 5th place car. You had a good hot rod again here today. You got yourself in position. You battled with Dale McDowell for the lead there side by side for a couple of laps. And on lap seven, when you took the lead, son, you done it again and just flat drove away from them. Excellent job.
Man, I got to thank the good Lord for letting me be here and letting us race, man. This is too awesome. I can't thank David Bryant, BJ Hillman for getting my car ready. This is actually a car I grew up racing at Dixie with, and man, it's obviously still pretty good. And man, what a car! I mean, it just drove so great. I can't thank them guys enough, man. They worked their tail off to get this thing ready, and I'm excited for the rest of the year. This was actually my first ever race on dirt, the Cabin Fever was, so to be able to get a win on it, that's too cool. I just speechless here.
Talk just a minute about, it seems like you and your crew chief David Bryant have garnered a very, very special working relationship through racing here, and what's that guy meant to your racing career?
I mean, it turned into a friendship, really. We're real close, and that's big. At the end of the year last year, we were on a stride where we didn't have a whole lot of good runs, but we were learning a lot, and you know, that's really big. You know, when you're down, not running real good, doesn't mean you're not trying. So we learned some things, and hey, it's too cool.
No, you got some sponsors you want to thank. We'll let you do that here also.
Thank Blunt Excavating, Massey Electric, Tennessee RV, McIntosh Performance. Everybody needs a hot rod, come on down. But man, this is too awesome.
Once again, race fans, give him a big round of applause. Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh, winner of the Cabin Fever 40 here this afternoon at Boyd Speedway.